everyone. Welcome. My name is Evan Jones, and I'm the sixth grade choir director here. The way we do things, if you're unfamiliar, we have a really big blessing here in Waconia. About 75% of our sixth graders are involved in the choir program. It's about 230 kids, and it's wonderful. We can't fit them on this stage. So we have the largest class do a concert, which is this hour, and then right after this, we have two classes together to make that work. So it's a great problem to have. We love it. They're doing an awesome job. And we're going to continue on with the dinner bell carol.
Thank you.
Awesome. So, the last piece, We Wish You a Merry Christmas, has a little bit of a twist, which I'll let you pick up on as you listen to it. If you are planning to stay for the second sixth grade concert with the two classes, you're more than welcome to. If you are planning to pick up your student that's up here, please go through these double doors to the music wing, and then take your student with you, because we're going to start the next concert right away. Thank you again for being here, and enjoy. We wish you a Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
as you guys can see, we're all very excited to be here today, which is great. I love it. I love that. So if you were here for the first part, which I'm sure a lot of you were, this is the other two-thirds of our choir. It's about 150 kids up here. We're going to move on for with the dinner bell carol. If you were not here earlier, I'm Evan Jones, and I'm the sixth grade choir director here, and we will continue with our concert with the dinner bell carol.
Ring in the trench, call lucky us, baby, tell us.
All right, for our last piece, we wish you a Merry Christmas. If you were not here, it's kind of a little different take on that. Thank you again for coming tonight. If you are coming to the 7th and 8th grade concert later tonight, we'll see you then too. Thanks for supporting your kids, and have a great evening.
Tradition. right, thank you so much for coming tonight. I'm so excited to share this music with you. As you can already see, this group is great at singing, a great seventh grade choir. So we've got about 120 students in our seventh grade choir this year that are all in this concert. And so we are going to go on to Carol of the Bells. In Carol of the Bells, most of my colleagues, if I told them I was doing Carol of the Bells with my seventh grade choir, would think I was crazy. But this group can totally handle it. When I heard them at the beginning of the year, I thought they can do this. So we're going to impress you now with Carol of the Bells. Featuring some of our soloists from the seventh grade choir. Enjoy. It's a medley of four different Christmas songs I think you'll recognize.
Thank you.
people I want to thank at this time for our last song. First of all, our accompanist Maria Grant, thank you so much for coming in again this year. And we also are just so thankful for our custodians for helping set up all of this, and for our administration, and just for our colleagues who let us take them out of class to rehearse the days of the concerts, and so just a great place to be. And so our next song, Home, has kind of been, I think, one of our favorites, and we've got some special instruments up here, guitar and cajon, during the song. But before that, we're gonna have some students read what home means to them. And what I had them do one day is they all wrote down a paragraph of what home means to them. And then I picked one reading from each hour. So the students reading them aren't necessarily the ones who wrote them, they're anonymous. But you'll hear from three of those entries of what home means to some of these students. And then from there, Mr. Jones is gonna conduct this song. He's also one of the directors of the seventh grade choir. So we're lucky to have two vocal people here at Clearwater. So yeah, we'll have them come up and read, and our instrumentalists get set. So.
Home is where the heart is. Home is where the Wi-Fi automatically connects. Home is where I express my feelings. Home is where I feel most loved. Home is where I can get free food.
Home is a place where I can be free to be who I am. Home is where I can bake, play games, watch movies with the people I love. Home is where I can meet my friends, hang out, and have sleepovers. Home is where I can express who I am and what I like to do. Home is where I can play outside when it's warm and sit cozy inside when it's cold. Home is where a place I'm not stressed, I am relaxed.
One final request that I've been building up for the students is at the end of this song, if you can have your, if you have a smartphone with a flashlight, have it ready to have a concert moment at the end of the song. In honor of this being a pop song. So I'll lead you in that at the end. During their last section, we will get out our cell phones and give them the performer moment that they've always been dreaming of. Here we go.
Yeah.
right. Thank you so much for participating with us. So, thank you again, students and parents, for a great concert, for your support, for your students who keep going in music. These guys are just, they're just great to work with. It's a highlight of my day to see them. So, thank you so much for your support and for coming out on this cold night, and enjoy the rest of your holiday season.
Evan Jones, that's me. I'm the 8th grade choir director here. These kids are awesome. They're super fun to work with. Just a joy to be around, good singers. So thank you, parents, families, and friends, for raising awesome kids. And welcome to our concert. We'll continue on. Our next song is Rather Be, and I'm gonna have our two soloists start coming down right now so you can make your way. And we'll continue with our concert.
There's no place I'd rather be. The Holocaust is a stunning reminder of the tragic results of prejudice and hate towards other people. But it is also a reminder that hope held firm will eventually reign victorious over the greatest of odds. The following words were inscribed on the walls of a cellar in Cologne, Germany, where Jews were hiding from the Nazis during World War II. Hope was all they had to hold on to. Hope was their only bridge to a brighter tomorrow.
That is one of the pieces. There's a few reasons why we chose that piece. One is that the eighth graders are studying that time period of the 1930s and 40s of World War II and the Holocaust and the things around it. So just a very appropriate thing to be like kind of coinciding with that. Also in February, our eighth graders will be singing at a convention in downtown Minneapolis at the Convention Center. It's a state music convention. Last spring, we auditioned to be a part of it, and were selected to be singers on the 16th of February. This is one of those pieces that we will be performing there. So we wanted to preview it to you. Our last piece is called Caroling Around the Christmas Tree. After this piece is done, if you could help us out just by stacking the same colored chairs, 10 chairs high, that would help us move things faster at the end. But thank you so much for being here. Your kids are great, and thank you for supporting them.
Thank you. Jacob.